Some of you might have been here in April or May when I mentioned that I knew two people who had done the New York Marathon twice each. And I said, well, I think Frisbee and Hong Kong. So I have a follow-up to that. And I realized it would become sort of this self-praising, major athletic achievement, well, for me anyway. But what actually is the story of friendship, and I think it's pretty cool. So I was riding up the Lehigh Valley Trail on a bike one day in March, and I happened to come across a poster that said, "Unleash your inner locomotive, run the Lehigh Valley Trail." Half marathon is the first time, coming back 5K. And I just walk. I just walk back and forth to my college in Manhattan, try to bus and so on. So I talked to my two friends, and one of them I've known since my days in college, which was many of you were not born yet. He's very Virgo. He's very young. Well, there's this, you can do this. There's running shoes, blah blah blah. And there's books. There's the internet. There's apps. Oh wait a minute. Can I say apps at my age? I don't want the generational police happening. And he makes all these things. He's talking like half an hour. I asked my other friend, who I had just met a few months ago, and she was much more to the point. Of course you can do it. So right away, he didn't know it at the time, but I had already been adopted by two coaches, who I will call my remote coach and my local coach. So I had a day, it was actually the second day of April. April Fool's would have been better, it would have been more appropriate, but April 2nd, I had a day of myself, and I decided to go to the Y, where there's an indoor track. And it's a 16th of a mile long if you run it once. Gee, George, how many laps is 5K? 50? Yeah, that's going to work really well. So 42 minutes later, I had finished them. And I wasn't dead, I'm here. And I walked most of them, but I sort of ran seven of them, and I picked up running shoes and so on, and I sort of get a little more serious about this. It'll happen. Decided to be brave one time and run two laps straight. And then I decided to be really brave and try to run three laps straight. Well, I came to a dead stop, and I wanted to pass out, throw up, and cough up my lungs all at the same time. Because that's what happens to new runners. So I go back and I start talking to my coaches. I mean, I have all the really good technical information, and over here I've got, of course you can do this. It's kind of a nice, cool juxtaposition. So I'm getting more and more confidence about this whole thing. And I decide, well, I've got to try to figure out some kind of game plan like this. Maybe I need one of my coaches to run around. So I approach local coaches and say, hey, why don't you do that for this thing? I'll do that when you're ready. This is April. I mean, when do you think that'll be? She says, June. June? Like, well, after a few minutes of being a bit uncomfortable with that, I realized she was right because she's run the New York Marathon twice, and I could just about do, 16th or 8th of a mile without coughing my lungs out. So I just started to do a little more, and then I discovered the canal trail and started to do some other things. There's a section of the canal trail where there's lampposts that were put up. And so I'm going to try to run to the next post. I'm going to try to run two posts. Then I'm going to get really great to run three posts. And then I wound up on the 21-meter safe course. Because what happened was I decided to get too ambitious, and on a Friday morning I decided to run at the Y at 5 a.m. And on a Saturday morning I was down in New Jersey and I said, I want to run the Manasquan Beach Trail, which is just a paved section. If you run back and forth twice, it's 5K. And somewhere in between the two of them, I blew up my plantar fascia. I didn't even know what that was, because of the Peyton Manning doc, because he was old. But, and he's a football player. So I was on the 21-day disabled list, and so, again, remote coach, I have dinner with him, we go through the whole chronology of everything that happened, how I created the perfect storm for myself by running 2 days in a row, not bringing my running shoes, trying to run Manasquan at 6 o'clock in the morning, because I'm stubborn. And from the local coach, I get, well, just put a golf ball in a sock, put the sock in the freezer, and here's what you do this, and just, it'll straighten out. But I just don't know. So eventually, I got it all back together, and May got a little better, and and then local coach proved to me I could run a minute and walk a minute. I'm like, you're nuts. They proved to me I could do it, and that 5K distance came down to 35 minutes that day from 42 at the Y the month before. Very cool. Then I did the Y again, and the next time I did it, I was down to 32 minutes the very next time. Well, what should happen? And there is a point to this. What should happen, but on June 3rd, it turns out there is this great release 5K that is on the part of the Canal Trail that I will just say practice on. I wasn't ready to say run on yet. And I said, well, I'll tell them about it. What's the worst that can happen if I sign up? You know, what's the worst that can happen? I'm not sure the worst that can happen, folks, is I could fall on my face in the mud and somebody could take a video like that and wind up on YouTube and go viral. That's probably the worst that could happen. That didn't happen. And I actually finished. And I finished in 32:13. So I was really happy with that. Where this is all leading up to is I found myself on July 4th on a ferry from my hometown of Jersey City over to Liberty Island in a t-shirt and running shorts to run something called the Statue of Liberty 5K, which is a fundraiser for Special Olympics New Jersey. And I had raised money and had my company match some of that money and so on, and there I am, just a little bit over a couple of months after starting this adventure, and here I am actually with 200 other people who are running around the Statue of Liberty on an absolutely gorgeous July 4th, 2016. And yes, when you have coaches, it's nice, and you have to still do it yourself. But I honestly think that without my two coaches and the friendship that they gave and the fact that they believed in me much more than I believed in myself when I did this, and they said either they gave me all the reasons why it was possible and how to get help and so on, or just said, I know you can do it. Between the two of them, who are dear friends, I was able to do it. So I think that fits in really well what we just heard and what the power of friendship really is. Oh, by the way, that Lehigh Valley Trail run, that's Sunday. And I'm finally going to do the one that I thought I could do back in March. So it'll be fun. And I actually broke 30 minutes the last time I ran that trail. So I'm very happy about that. So I guess if there's a moral of this story,